Hi friends, in last two lectures we studied about cement. Today we do the revisions for the all content covered in cement. As per the syllabus, the content of cement is the cement, definition of cement, what are the methods or processes for the manufacturing of cement, what are the chemical ingredient of cement, what are the chemical components of cement, and different types of test, in which field test and laboratory test we are studied in last few lectures. Today we do the revision for it. Cement, the objective are already discussed. After studying this topic, the student will be able to describe the manufacturing process of cement, then chemical composition of cement. The student will able to describe the physical properties of cement, classify the various types of cement, explaining their uses, then verify the quality of cement by different tests, then get acquainted with the laboratory testing of Portland cement, in which we saw the definition of cement is that it is a proper mixture of calcareous and argillaceous material. Cement is defined as the product manufactured by burning and crushing to powder and intimate and well proportional mixture of calcareous and argillaceous material. Means what? The cement is a mixture of calcareous and argillaceous material in well proportion of chemicals, and the mixture of both material is well grinded in a mill. Then what is meant by calcareous material? The percentage of calcium is higher in material that are known as calcareous material. Then argillaceous material, the argillaceous materials contain alumina as their main ingredient. The various argillaceous materials are shale, clay, laterite, etc. These materials provides the required proportion of silica, alumina, oxide of iron, etc. to the cement. Then we saw the manufacturing processes, the weight and dye process are used to manufacture of cement. The main difference between weight and dye process: in weight process we add water and make slurry of cement, and then the slurry to be dried in by the air, and the in high, at high temperature the clinkers are formed due to fusion of various chemical components. Then clinkers are grinded in a mill in a fine powder form, and then the cement is packed in required weight, and the bags or barrels are distributed. These are the methods of manufacturing of cement, that is weight and dry process. This is flow chart of weight process, in which first of all calcareous materials, that is limestone, and argillaceous material, that is clay, are taken. Calcareous materials are crushed in small pieces, and argillaceous materials are washed thoroughly with the help of water. Then both are stored in silos. Then through channels they are graded. Then water is added and form slurry. In the correction basin, the proportion of all the chemical ingredients are corrected. Then all the mixture is stored in storage tanks in rotary kiln, in which the kiln, the mixture is rotated throughout. Because of that, the material is not stuck in the container. Then at high temperature, the clinkers are formed. The temperature in kiln is about 1500 degrees Celsius. At this time, the gypsum in 2 to 3% is added in this mixture. For that, the initial setting time of cement is prolonged by the, that is the function of gypsum is as retarder, that is admixture, the other material added for prolonging the time. Then the clinkers are cold and then grinded in clinker in ball mill and tube mill. That is, the material is formed in the grinding mill is cement. The mix cement is stored in silos. Then according to requirement, the cement is weighed and packing in bags and then distribution. The entire process of manufacturing of cement is same as wet process. Only difference is that that the water is not added in dry process. All other steps are same according to wet process. These are the manufacturing processes of cement. Then chemical composition of cement. The main ingredients of cement are lime, silica and alumina. The percentage of lime ranges from 60 to 67%. The percentage of silica lies between 17 to 25%, and the percentage of alumina is between 3 to 8%. All other ingredients like iron oxide, magnesium oxide, sulfur oxide and alkali are in small percentage. According to that, the different functions of ingredient in the cement. Lime is major ingredient of cement. It gives the strength to the cement. Likewise, silica also provides strength. Alumina lowers the clinkering temperature. It provides quick setting property to the cement. Then iron oxide. The main function of iron oxide is providing the color to the cement. Then magnesium oxide. It also gives color to the cement. Then sulfur trioxide. Sulfur trioxide makes the cement sound if present in very small quantity. Then chemical composition of cement. Tricalcium silicate, dicalcium silicate, tricalcium aluminate and tetracalcium aluminoferrate. These are the basic four compounds formed at the in the kiln at high temperature due to fusion of different ingredient of cement. The range of tricalcium silicate is from 25 to 50%, dicalcium silicate 21 to 45%, tricalcium aluminate is 5 to 11%, and tetracalcium aluminoferrate is ranges from 9 to 14%. These all compounds are also known as bogus compounds. They are found at the time of manufacturing of cement in clean at higher temperature, near about 1500 degrees Celsius. Then we saw the functions of different components, then types of cement. As according to purpose and function of cement, there are 11 basic types of cement. First is ordinary, that is OPC, ordinary Portland cement. Then rapid hardening Portland cement, then low heat Portland cement, sulfate resisting cement, blast furnace slag cement, white and color cement, high alumina cement, pozzolana cement, oil well well cement, expanding cement, and quick sitting tank cement. Mainly we use ordinary Portland cement, rapid hardening Portland cement. Then other types of cement we use according to or as per requirement, like color cement, oil well cement. Oil well cement is mostly used in wells of oil. Color cement is mostly used for appearance or aesthetic view. Sulfate resisting cement is used for the structure standing in continuously standing in water for resisting sulfate attack. Due to that, the corrosion of material in concrete is avoided. And rapid hardening Portland cement, when the urgency is required in any kind of work, like when the maintenance of crude is required, and at this time rapid hardening Portland cement is used. And other ordinary work we use OPC. And one more type is PPC, that is pozzolana Portland cement. Ordinary Portland cement gives yield stress, ultimate strength, at the end of 28 days, and rapid hardening cement gives strength before 28 days, or it gives early strength to the cement earlier than OPC. Then testing of Portland cement, the all test which studying that are on only OPC, that is ordinary Portland cement. The main tests are field testing and laboratory testing. The field test done on the cement are: open the bag, insert your hand in the cement bag. It will feel cool when we insert our hand in the cement bag. Otherwise, the hydration reaction of that cement is happen due to presence of moisture in the atmosphere. Second, rub cement in two fingers. It would feel smooth, that is fine. Then throw some cement in a bucket of water. The particles of cement float for some time, then they will be settled down. Then the color of cement should be uniform gray. Then in lab testing, there are various test: chemical composition, fineness, consistency, setting time in which initial and final sitting time of swimming, then soundness test and compressive strength, then tensile strength. The chemical composition is the ratio of percentage of alumina to that of iron oxide should not be less than 0.66. Ratio of percentage of lime to those of alumina, iron oxide and silica should not be less than 0.66 and should not be greater than 1.02. When calculated by the formula, we see the formula on the screen. The total loss on ignition should not be greater than 4% at the time of manufacturing of cement. The total loss is not, it should not be greater than 4%. The total sulfur content is calculated as SO3 and it should not be greater than 2.75%. The weight of magnesia should not exceed 5%. Then a fineness test in which we take 100 grams of cement, sieve through sieve number 9. The size of that sieve is 90 micron for 15 minutes. After 15 minutes of shaking, the residue on retain on that sieve should not be greater than 10%. Then cement will be finer for and useful for any kind of construction work. Beyond 10%, the cement is not eligible or much finer. Means the hydration reaction was happened in that cement and the full strength will not attain by that cement. Therefore, that kind of cement will be rejected. Then consistency of cement. In simple words, the consistency of cement means the water required for full hydration reaction of cement, that is consistency of cement. Mainly 38% water is required for full hydration, in which 23% is for hydration and 15% is required for filling the gaps in when hydration reaction is happen. Hydration reaction is the reaction happen when the water is to be added in a cement. The reaction between cement and water, that is hydration reaction. The consistency of cement means the water required for full hydration of the cement. The consistency test we done should done with the help of FICAT apparatus in the concrete technology lab. This is a figure of FICAT apparatus. This apparatus is used for consistency strength test on cement and setting time of cement, that is initial setting time and final setting time. The initial setting time should not be less than 30 minutes and final setting time should not be more than 600 minutes for ordinary Portland cement. Then soundness of cement. Soundness means the phenomenon by virtue of which cement does not undergo large change in volume when treated with water is called as soundness. The member or cubes formed by the cement does not change its dimension after treating with water, that is soundness test. With the help of Lee Chatelier's apparatus, we can find out the soundness of cement. Then compressive strength test. According to grades of cement, द कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ सीमेंट शुड बी नियर एज पर कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ और ग्रेड ऑफ सीमेंट. द ग्रेड्स ऑफ सीमेंट आर 33, 43 एंड 53. फॉर दैट वी यूज द मोर्टर ऑफ 1:3 प्रोपोर्शन इन दैट मीन्स वन पार्ट ऑफ सीमेंट टू द थ्री पार्ट ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड सैंड. द मोड्स यूज फॉर दिस टेस्ट आर हैज़ डायमेंशन ऑफ 70.6 मिलीमीटर बाय 70.6 मिलीमीटर बाय 70.6 मिलीमीटर एंड द क्यूब्स आर मोल्डेड एंड कीप फॉर क्यूरिंग पर्पज फॉर 3 days, 7 days एंड 28 days. आफ्टर दैट द क्यूब्स आर रिमूव्ड फ्रॉम द क्यूरिंग टैंक फॉर द टेस्ट एंड द फॉर द टेस्ट 3 क्यूब्स आर यूज एंड दे एवरेज ऑफ दिस 3 विल बी टेकन फॉर द फाइनल रिजल्ट. देन टेंसल स्ट्रेंथ टेस्ट. दिस टेस्ट वॉज फॉर्मली यूज टू गेट द इनडायरेक्ट इंडिकेशन ऑफ कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ सीमेंट. दिस टेस्ट जनरली डन ऑन रैपिडली हार्डनिंग सीमेंट इन विच एज पर गिवन फिगर द पैकेट ऑफ मेटल्स आर यूज फॉर टेस्टिंग सीमेंट फॉर टेंसल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ सीमेंट. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट सीमेंट इन विच वी सी द डेफिनेशन मटेरियल्स यूज फॉर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट द प्रोसेस ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सीमेंट देन टाइप्स ऑफ सीमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू पर्पज एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ इनग्रेडियंट देन केमिकल इनग्रेडियंट ऑफ सीमेंट केमिकल कंपोनेंट ऑफ सीमेंट एंड द डिफरेंट टेस्ट ऑन सीमेंट डन ऑन फील्ड एंड इन लैब. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट सीमेंट. थैंक यू.